Yes, we are doing it again. It's 2024, Blender is now 4.2, and just, why not? Model, collision, and material, all in one video, and the best of all, no physics, so even the oldest laptop can follow along. Start by deleting the default cube. Add in some text, I'll write 2024, you can write whatever you want. Then I'll go into the data property tabs, go into font, choose a folder, and open Arial Black. Set the align to center and set it to middle. I will then press F3, convert to mesh. Then I'll go into edit mode by pressing tab, press A, press E, and then we can extrude our mesh. Go into your modifiers, add a vMesh modifier, set the voxel size to 0.015, then apply, go into your shading, go into your sculpting, go down to your color filter, is this icon, choose inflate. While hovering over your text, drag to the right. If it flies away, just do it in small amounts, so I'll just click drag like so, and the last thing I'm going to do is go back to layout, right click and shade smooth. That's how you make inflated text. Now if you want to make it inflate inside a box, we can just hide this, add in a box, go into edit mode, choose face select tool, select the top face, insert it and extrude it down with E, add in a new text, move it to the side, press tab to edit. I'll just write year 2024. First we need to add the Arial Black. I'll convert to mesh. Then I'll go into edit mode, to the top view, to wireframe. If you hold your mouse over a letter, press L, you are able to select it all. Press G to move and press R to rotate. Now I'm just going to adjust it so it matches inside the box. Inside edit mode, I'll add in a circle. Press F to fill it with a face and scale it down and fill in the blank space. Then I'm going to extrude it up. And I'm going to press A, select it all, and move it close to the top. Then I'm going to add the vMesh modifier, going back into a solid view, and I'll just drag the voxel size down until they don't collide anymore. Then I'll apply. And then for later, I'll add two materials, one being text, and the other one being circles. I'll go back into edit mode, pressing L while hovering over everybody, L, and then I'll assign it to the circles. Then you can make a different viewport color, like so. Going into sculpting, this time turn on collision, do the same thing, tap swipe, and you'll see it will also collide with the edges, like so. Now I'll scale down my box just a little, and that's how you make the box. Remember to shade smooth. Now we're going to make the materials and a scene. I'll use the other text as an example. Just hide these two, also in the render, and then I'll bring back the text. I'll call it 2024 so I can find it in my outline. Now I'll just rotate the text, pressing R, X, 90. Then I'll add in a camera, move it on the Y axis, pressing N, and then I'll rotate it 90, 0, 0. Now we'll reface my text. I will change the resolution to 1080 by 1080. Then I'll go into the camera by pressing 0 on my numpad. Then I'll change the focal length to 70 and move the Y axis up here until I have the right frame I want, like so. Then I'll add in a plane, rotate it by 90 on the X axis. Move it back a little, scale it up so it fits inside the frame. Then I'm going to navigate to Ambient CG to download a HDRi. I have chosen the one on the screen right now, and I'll link it down below in the description. Then I'm going to add it in, going into the shader editor, choosing world, pressing shift A, searching environment texture, dragging the color into the color, open, find your folder and find the environment texture. Then I'll go back into layout, press the render view, choose cycles, down in film, I'll choose transparent so we don't render it. Then I'll choose my GPU instead of the CPU and turn on denoising. And while we are here, I'll set the noise threshold for the render to 0.01, like so. Then I'm going to change the material of my text. So in material tabs, I'll choose text, then I'll choose glossy, and then I'll turn down the roughness to 0.25, and I'll choose a golden color, like so. And if you go into your view, you can see your text. I'll just make the environment stronger, so I'll make it 2 in strength. Then I'll go into my render view again, going down to color management, choosing base contrast as a look. Choosing medium high contrast as a look. Then I'm going to add an area light to add some highlight. Move to the side and turn the knob towards my text. I already have way more highlight, but I'm going to make it even stronger, maybe twice. I like that. If you make it smaller, you can get some shadows, like so. And that's it. That's how you make a 3D text in Blender. I hope you liked it, and I'll see you again soon.